You're getting married.
I didn't make a toast at your wedding, but I thought a vlog would probably be even more appropriate coming from me. So of course we had to do one last cooking time lapse while you were still Valerie Christophic instead of Mrs. Valerie Mac. Then we all got to hang out at your house for a little bit before you went over to the church to get ready. But driving over to the church didn't really feel like you were getting married. It felt more like we were all piling into Abigail's car to drive to a graduation party like we had just a few summers ago.
You're getting hitched. You get to sleep.
Finally.
We think. We hope. At least on the honeymoon when we're in a king-size bed with a double bed, I'm not so sure.
And not kidding you.
I like her a lot.
You can provoke her afterwards. This is just not all the road. Years where you've almost gotten us killed while I'm driving.
That is not my fault.
And I mean, really, in the grand scheme of things, how different is a time lapse of you getting your hair done for your wedding from the time lapse of you getting your hair dyed blue last summer? Wedding dress, not because you weren't absolutely gorgeous, but because we all know how much you deserve this. Of course, because I was in your wedding, I didn't get footage of your actual wedding, but I will never forget the look on Isaac's face as he was marrying you. And I think that's what we all love so much about your relationship, is knowing that you are with someone who loves you and appreciates you as much as we do, and even more so as your husband.
Val, you is married!
You're married!
You're married!
Ah!
When I first met Val, I
realized
that there were a few things that were apparent right away. That she was brilliant, especially when it came to coding, because she was really good at that, and I was absolutely clueless about that during my freshman year.
That's okay.
Another thing that was apparent is that she loved Jesus, and that she had a wonderful sense of humor.
Because of our relationship, I've had a front row seat to your relationship with Val, and I still remember the day that when we were talking shortly after their first date, he comes up to me with this dopey grin on his face, and he says, "Caitlin, she's gorgeous." He was right, and it's been his great pleasure to brag on her ever since.
But she's been there for everything. She was the maid of honor in my wedding when she was 11, and she's held each of my boys when they were born. We've been all over together, from the Big Apple to the beach to the boat, and I really don't have enough time to do justice to all the memories that I have with my sweet, sweet sister and our family, or how much she means to us and to me.
I can't edit this part without crying because the look on Isaac's face is so clear and obvious. And I think, again, we all know how much you deserve this and how wonderful it is that you get to enjoy Isaac being the wonderful person that he is for the rest of your life, and also that he knows what a wonderful person you are and is able to enjoy you for the rest of your lives. And that's just the serious side of your relationship. I mean, there's also the fun-loving side that's clearly demonstrated here.
Val, we all love you both so much, and we know that...